I shed a tear for not knowing that Modesto is still part of my state.
What do you make of a proposal like the Six Californias Initiative, which would carve California up into, you know, six regions, some of which are more intuitive than others, right? I mean, sort of, oh, Northern California, it's trees, leafy, people didn't really want to be in California anyway. They feel like they got the shaft by the Oregonian legislature as well as by Sacramento. But some of the other divisions are a little more controversial. What do you think?
I mean, you know, make the Central Valley its own thing. That's a weird place. That's a weird state. Like, you make all the agriculture and all the meth. You have 15% unemployment and really bad pollution. I'm in favor, generally speaking, of decentralizing stuff and also kind of ripping stuff up from its roots just for fun to see what happens to it. At the same time, we've been around now for long enough that it's kind of hard to wrap your mind around how these things would happen and then what would that do to the collective California identity. And I don't know, man. I mean, as a Southern Californian, I am, you know, obviously irritated at Northern California. It's just by you know, waking up in the morning. But at the same time, every time I go to San Francisco, I think that's my state's history. You know, if I go to Nevada City, the whole history of California is pretty interconnected culturally. And though you can make a good governance case for breaking it up and let the freakers in Jackson do whatever they want to do, which is basically sell a whole bunch of weed, I guess. At the same time, you know, I would shed a tear for not knowing that Modesto is still part of my state and other places.
One of the big critiques coming from the left when presented with Six Californias is this is just those greedy Silicon Valley tech titans trying to create their own statelet so that they are free from Sacramento regulation. You know, the same horrible people that want to build cities in the ocean. What could be worse than that?
Yeah.
Do you think that Silicon Valley as it is now, and I know where this is painting with a broad brush, but there's a crossroads, right, where they can kind of go down this disruptive and innovative road and apply that thinking to politics, or they can say, look, we just want to make our money and drive around in our driverless cars, and, you know, so long as people who agree with us culturally are in Sacramento, we can, you know, we're genius enough to beat the system no matter how bad it is.
I think the way that Silicon Valley ends up adding value to the political system is more by making the driverless cars than going to Sacramento and lobbying for driverless car policy. They'll do both ultimately, but it's you know, doing Singularity University and like being way out there in the MOOC and online education stuff. The thing that's going to break up the public education nightmare in this country, I think, is going to be a combination of the individual choice that people have been making out there, and the MOOC stuff is right there, right on the edge of it. And also hiring practices are important. If Silicon Valley just sort of decided, and maybe they have, and I'm unaware of it, of like, you know what, I'm not interested in the credential or the signaling of your 4-year degree from Berkeley or UCLA or Claremont or anywhere else. I'm not actually interested in that. I'm interested in either you have the specific like certificate of the thing that applies to me, or you just show me your work. Like the cultural ripples that they can create, I think, will ultimately be more interesting than what they do when they try to reinvent politics. And I would fear, just kind of knowing where a lot of their cultural values would be, is that they would just end up getting mostly excited about not being around troglodyte Republicans and giving cultural kind of signaling of, you know, we don't hate gay people and black people and Mexicans, and so we'll just sort of generically support a Democratic agenda that is otherwise really kind of not consistent with their values. So I want them to create stuff.
You talk about the credential of a good 4-year college and the sort of diminishing value that has nowadays. Do you think if we fix sort of pre-college education, then maybe what looks like this horrendous malfunctioning college system will become less of a problem?
Yeah. Right?
If everyone sort of changes the way they think about higher education, then higher education might just start changing by itself afterwards.
It's hard for higher education to change by itself because it has just it's acquired all of this cement. You know, they've literally just been building buildings like crazy and hiring all this administration kind of the muck there. And to the extent that that overlaps with the public sector and its more stringent rules about things, then that can also be problematic. But yeah, if you make K through 12 better, then you don't have to make college a remedial class. And that might make community colleges in California, which I've gone to, and they're perennially underrated as a source of pretty decent education out there. That moves them out of the remedial education and actually gets you some kind of quality there. Then that helps a great deal. It doesn't fix it ultimately. Fixing it, I was talking with someone here earlier, like talking about the higher education bubble, which is great. It's a great theme, but like, what pops? What is the thing that pops? It's not like higher real estate prices that, okay, it pops. People start paying for less. So it's going to be a huge problem, especially in California.
It's the market value of a good education.
Yeah, well, they're not going to have motivated customers anymore. So it's going to make politics about like, okay, we really need to defrock the UC system, the Cal State system, and go after salaries of the top educators, but mostly go after the administrative blow to these places and kind of readjust. But those institutions are not geared to be flexible and respond to that.